before we start, I just want to thank some people. First staff, Paula, Julie, Jen, Nick, Paula. Thank you for doing that. I can't thank Paula without thanking Matt for doing time for this, including setting up more chairs for everyone so we can all have a place to sit. Gretchen for helping with the decorations, donating a lot of what you see here, putting it all together, coming in during the day.
That was Paula putting it all together. Just
draw
what you want.
Okay, Paula gets the credit. Congrats again, Paula. The board, they're all sitting over, most of them are sitting there. Julie, Bob, Gretchen, Lisa, and Kyle is probably on TV right now on CSN, so he's not here. And thank you, everyone, for coming. This is awesome. It's the first time we've done this, and judging by the turnout, it won't be the last, so thank you. But before we get to the winners tonight, I want to talk about the one real winner in this place, that of course being me. No, seriously, I'm incredibly lucky. I get to come to work every day, work with you people, everyone out here, whether you work behind the scenes, whether you do a show. I get to learn all sorts of things from everyone. Everyone does different shows, has different talents, so on any given day, I learn about gardening, government, law, history, music, video games, education, veterans, clowns, nature, the COA, fantasy football, and of course, you can forget professional wrestling. Thank you, Canada. We built an awesome community here. Everyone, we really have a community access station, a community television station, and I'm proud to be part of it, even as a facilitator or whatever I get to do. It's awesome, awesome, awesome to work with you. So, before, when we talk about community, I do have to start on a somewhat more somber note. We lost one of the most important members of our community this year, that being Joe Sarah. Joe's family is here. I'd like to acknowledge them, thank them for coming. And as part of this, I'd like to thank the COA, because Joe used to like to joke that he came here looking for the senior center. He was in the wrong building. We managed to pick him, so thank you for that, COA. But he started as a volunteer working behind the scenes, and we eventually convinced him to become a board member. And on top of that, he did a lot of great stuff for us. He fixed a lot of equipment that I thought was never going to get fixed. One of my favorite things he did was one time on a Bedford, particularly crazy Bedford Common, we had a goat chew through a microphone in the studio. Oh, see, don't tell anyone. And Joe fixed it for us, so thank you, Joe. He ran a new cable. And he was just great. We loved having him in. He was always just such a funny, entertaining, just great guy. And we still use the things he taught us. He was such a methodical person when it came to fixing problems. He would never just fix something. He would bring out the manual and show you why it went from point A to point B and all the steps in between and which one wasn't working and how to fix it. So now when we have problems, we still use the Joe Sarah technique. So thanks, Joe. So, I'd like to start by just having a moment of silence for Joe before we kick off the awards. Thank you, everyone. And the first award is the Joe Sarah Most Valuable Crew Member Award. So this goes to, since Joe is such a valuable part of our community, this goes to someone who has gone above and beyond to help us out on different shoots and just do a lot behind the scenes. And I'll start by listing the nominees. First, we have Anne, who's sitting in the back. Anne, you can raise your hand. Anne was one of the first people I met at this job, which tells you how long Anne has been volunteering with us. It's been a very long time. She does the audio for the news every week and helps out with whatever fires we need to put out, inevitably when the show is starting in 10 minutes and I'm running around. Anne's always there, calming influence to help, and as is Steve, our next nominee, who has covered a ton of things in the field. He's gone and done events, rotary events, a lot of things. I would start listing them. That's probably a bad idea if we want to get out of here. Bob Dutton, who's a board member, is a treasurer of our board, also switches the news, which is one of the most demanding, if not the most demanding, I think, volunteer positions, because Bob, never have everything fully prepared for you when you come in. Pat Levan, who was the former head of the COA. I'm not sure if she's here.
Probably
in
Italy or something.
Huh. Not bad. But Pat helps out with the COA show, and she's always great to have around. And then Leo, who switches the COA program, former board member, and we're happy to have all these nominees. And I will say, in every category, nothing was a runaway. These were all very close, so it is an honor to be nominated. And just logistically, when you win your award, you're going to walk over here, We're going to hand you your award. You're going to take your picture with our VIP, George. Then you can come up here, and if you want to make some quick remarks, you can. If you start to go over a minute, I'm going to signal to Mark to start bringing up the music and play you off the stage. So it's not Mark's fault. It's mine. So the first winner is Bob Dutton. Start to move a little quicker now because I'll talk forever. The next category is Best Musical Performance. We have a lot of great talented musicians who come in here and play for us, and the nominees are
Alan Joe and Marco De Peralta, Bedford TV Studio Marathon.
Jarring of judgment and reasons defeated, the sweet heat of her breath and mom of her life, with the sweet sand breath and her tongue so mean, she's the angel of small death and the accordion scene.
Penn Passering, Nature Sounds. Mike Kelly, CC Clownsby and Company, Rock and Roll. John Kinsley, Wizard Music. Seamus Gersey, Joe Ramage, and Kevin Daugherty, VA Creative Arts Festival.
Amy, what you wanna do? I think I can stay with you for a while, maybe longer if I do.
So like I said, great nominees. And the winner for this one is Alan Joe. Something on their behalf would be George Clooney. So, our next category is the Best Solo Host. This is an ultra-competitive one as well, so here are the nominees.
Mary Kay Elohian, The Legal Edition.
Hello and welcome to The Legal Edition. I'm your host, attorney Mary Kay Elohian. Our show topic today, autism and environmental toxins, mercury, medicine, and money. Our guest is Mr. Mark Blaxall. He's the co-author of the best-selling book, Age of Autism, and also Vaccines 2.0.
Wayne Braverman, Celebrate Life.
Greetings, welcome to Celebrate Life. My name is Wayne Braverman. It is a pleasure to be with you for this time that we will share together. I have a special guest with me, Lei Wang. Lei doesn't know what we're doing today because she's actually here for another show that we're going to do. And I thought it would be fun to have her here. She's originally from China. She went through the Chinese education system. She doesn't know, well, she does know about the American system because she went to a couple of colleges while she was here. But this is our education special.
Don Kachubis, Bedford Backstage.
Hello, welcome music fans. Today we have another fun episode of Bedford Backstage for you. With me today is superstar Natalie Lewis.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me. Thank
you. So nice that you're here.
Patty Carluccio, Pretty Simple Gardens.
Sometimes I'll actually cut the bigger seeds off and go plant them elsewhere like I've done with my peonies. So the fourth thing you're going to want to do is to trim off any dead branches on your bushes or your trees. The good news is, because of the drought, it's not a good idea to really hack away at your bushes and cut them way back. They're very stressed right now, and in addition, in these bushes...
Maureen Sullivan, Chamber Connections.
I know that you're still writing. You are still writing for the Globe?
I stopped last year. I have had such a wonderful career at the Globe, and I may pitch another story. I want to do a story on the buskers, they're called, people who do art and music in the subway. I can't.
All right, so moment of truth. The winner, and let me make sure I'm opening the correct envelope and giving it to the correct person, is Wayne Brothers.
So I emailed my significant other and told her what was happening tonight, and I said that winners could give speeches. And she emailed me back and she said, if you happen to win an award, don't you dare stand up there and tie up the time. You need to come home as soon as this thing is over, and don't drag this thing over. So I will keep it simple. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure and an honor to be part of this wonderful organization. And I look forward to see what we all can create during the next year. Thank you very much.
All right, and our next one that we have up here is for makeup and costume. We have a lot of really interesting makeup and costume that comes in here, and people put in a lot of effort and deserve to be recognized for it. So here are the nominees.
Zach Martinkus, The Wrestling Connection.
It's like Paige is trying to do the exact same thing. And I'm sorry, Paige, but I'm speaking to you straight one-on-one here. If you got your head on straight though, even though I'm older than you, believe it or not, if you got your head on straight though, you know exactly what the heck you want in life though, you got a great company you're a part of for crying out loud, you want to completely screw that over for a guy who's twice your age, is probably your biggest meal ticket, right the heck ahead.
Jen Pula, Don Kachubis, Dan Broskell, and Maria Wilson, the Bedford TV News.
Dan Broskell, who has been on BTV Vacation for a while, and we thank him, or whatever on earth that is, that's sitting next to me right now, for joining us. Dan.
Bill LaRicka and Reading. That was a pretty good one, Don. Pretty good one.
Like that? That lasted 3 seconds, really.
Check it out. There we go. Anyway, sports.
Mike Kelly, CC Clownsby and Company, Rock and Roll. John Kinsley, Wizard Music.
Too. Has anybody here been to North Africa?
CC Clownsby and Company. We weren't sure if we were going to get, we got a nomination, but clowns sometimes, you know, we come for the fun, we come for the party, you know what I mean? But we We would have had a longer speech, but we couldn't find the Scotch tape. And I will make it quick. I thought I was going to read the speech. Well, you can read the first part. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Bedford TV, thank you.
The next one is Rookie of the Year, so Steve joined us a little less than a year ago. I had to look to make sure you qualified, but you do. And I talked about Steve before, and he does a ton for us, which is great. Wayne, as you saw his clip before, with Celebrate Life. Then we have Prakar, who took the middle school class. Prakar is out there somewhere. Say hi, Prakar. He does a show called Video Game Fight Club with a live stream video games, and he does that with Alex Doherty for a lot of the episodes, and he's sitting back there with him. And Alex also took the middle school class, helps out a lot around the studio, and they're both great. So let's see who won. Steve McMahon.
Do most of my work behind the scenes, but I just want to thank everybody at Bedford TV, and especially Bedford TV News. It's a blast to work there and go out and film the town. There's so many things going on. I enjoy it so much, and I've learned everything, especially from Ann Siemens. Thanks again.
So the next one we have is the live show of the year. We do a lot of our shows live. I said in my report how many it was, and I was astounded enough to not remember. I know we do 180 episodes of VHS Live a year, and I believe it was around 150 other shows that are live. So the nominees are...
VHS Graduation, Bedford TV.
Hello, family and friends. Hi, teachers. Hey, classmates. Do you guys remember, back in elementary school, when you try to imagine what you would look like upon graduating high school? What you would be like, what you would have accomplished? I know I did. And this is not entirely what elementary school Avery would have predicted.
The Wrestling Connection, 100th episode, Spectacular.
So we had the Fatal 4-Way Tag Team Match. For the kickoff match, mm-hmm. determined that which set of participants won would get into the Rumble match. We had the Ascension, we had the Dudley Boys, we had Damian Sandow and Darren Young.
Mike Mahoney, Greg Dolan, Nick Giglio, Ken Hill, Wayne Braverman, Jen Pula, Julian Triasian, Maria Wilson, Ben Osinski, Gus Weedy, Ann Siemens, Steve McMahon, Alan Joe, and Marco De Peralta, the Bedford TV Studio Marathon.
This is a special edition. My name is Wayne Braverman. Not that I'm special, but this edition is special because it is being done live.
And then, how did he get his name?
This is the old intro.
The original intro, right?
So that I can take credit for this. This is a Greg Dolan production.
It's like taking a trip down memory lane.
This is a good one.
The farther from Earth we look,
it's really long, though.
And welcome to a special feature-length midnight edition. Not quite midnight, but who's
WK
counting?
After Dark.
Ken After Dark.
Jen Pula, Don Kachubis, Dan Broskell, and Maria Wilson, the Bedford TV News Halloween Special.
I have a Halloween pun. Why did the ghost join the cheerleading team?
We don't know. Why? Why?
Because she had a lot of spirit.
Oh! We're gonna give you a high five for that one.
Wow! High five.
Nice one.
So until next week, back to you, Jen and Don.
So we won't be here next week because we'll be trick-or-treating and taking all the kids' candy.
Lots and lots and lots and lots of students. VHS Live.
Today, Thursday, is senior locker / iPad cleanout. It will be going on all day, and iPad collection will be held in the LGI. So be sure to clean out your locker and drop your iPads off.
All right, so the winner is a lot of people, the Bedford TV Studio Marathon. So, just to explain what that award really quickly, everyone's name is listed, feel free to come on out and accept this award and take a picture. So please, anyone who saw their name for that. So we did a 14-hour studio marathon. We kicked it off at about 11 a.m. and we went till, or 10 a.m., we went until midnight. We're hoping to do it again sometime in the winter and do 24 hours. Keep your eyes peeled for that. So I'm going to get the wide angle lens out. I'll be right. Sports and all sorts of other things. So look out for that in the future. All right, so the next category we have is most viral. So the way we figured out nominees for this is we went through our social media channels and found what the most popular posts were. So the nominees are
BHS Graduation, Bedford TV.
One last round of applause for the class of 2016, please. Congratulations, you are officially confirmed. Have a wonderful night. Congratulations, class of 2016.
Ken Hill and Zach Martinkus winning the ACM Northeast Award for Best General Talk Show.
What place do you think you got?
I'm afraid to ask. Did we come in third?
Not third.
Did we come in second?
Not second.
We came in first.
Yeah!
We came in first!
Oh, yeah! Yeah!
We are the champions, my friends.
VA Ribbon Cutting, Bedford Green Opening Ceremony.
Okay, are you ready?
Ready?
Bedford Dash, the Bedford Citizen.
Renu is using the Dash to get home from work today. We're in Burlington and we're getting ready to take off and drive to Bedford.
I'm very excited about doing this ride because I've been looking for options of getting back and forth from work.
All right, thank you. And that last clip, just to explain, was filmed on my old cell phone. But the Dash was such a popular thing. And it's really powerful. You can just pull out your phone and go right to Facebook. And we got a lot of people on watching immediately, so it's really cool. That being said, the winner is Bedford High School Graduation. So accepting for them, even though he doesn't know, is Dan Rostin, the school committee. Graduation was great. We'll do it again next time. fun nominees. Let's see them.
Mike Kelly, CC Clownsby, and Cowboy Mike.
As he climbed in the chute, he proud held his breath. He was seconds from glory, a moment from death. He knew with this bow, he could go either way. He said, let her go, boys, and pray.
Pempasering traditional Tibetan dance. Ken Hill, The Wrestling Connection, 100th episode. Zach Martinkus and Julian Warren, What a Maneuver.
Right around. Well, so, like, I'm going to do with this for example, all right?
Yep.
Ready? And basically, they just, and this is what how that you do it. You just grip on as tightly as you can, though, on both sides.
And as you can see, my legs are getting steadily tired, and he falls down, he could still have me in the hold. I either could tap out to say my version of uncle, or I could just pass out and get the automatic your winner by knockout, Zach Martinkus.
All right, and the winner for best choreography is a tie between Ken Hill for The Wrestling Connection and Zach Martinkus and Julian Warren, also for The Wrestling Connection. I think Ken's the only one here, so Ken, I won't tell them to get the award.
First, I'm honored to win this award and bring back the only one single dance craze from the 90s. And, of course, I do have to give a sisto to Penpa, who actually did have quite a few dancing cameos on The Wrestling Connection. If you look closely enough, Greg usually manages to slip them in there. Oh, and Nick.
It's all me.
It's all. He takes it. Anyway, thank you very much, and of course I accept on behalf of Zach and Julian, who can't be here, but this goes out to them too. Thank you.
All right, and next up we have some very good nominees here looking at it. This is the Best Ensemble Cast, so this is for programs that have more than one host. So, the nominees are...
Jen Pula, Don Kachubis, Dan Broskell, Maria Wilson, and Jason Gould, The Bedford TV News.
What a crazy day.
Very windy.
Yeah, it's the kind of day where you just get knots in your hair for no reason.
True. We'll have to make sure we pay attention later when we do the weather with Maria to find out what it will be like for the rest of the week.
Oh, I hope Dr. Gould accurately predicts the wind.
Me too.
Ken Hill, Zach Martinkus, and Julian Warren, The Wrestling Connection.
The most must-see.
Must-see.
Most running, award-winning talk show to ever hit the Bedford TV airwaves, or the Massachusetts airwaves,
or the
New England airwaves,
or over the freaking world,
the Wrestling Connection.
Mike Mahoney, Greg Dolan, Nick Giglio, and Brian Dorrington, the Sports Scholars.
The guy is a freak of nature, and how athletic he is, how like durable he is. You know, he's the only guy who could actually come back from an ACL tear and do better than he did last year. So, I mean, there's really no reason not to pick Adrian Peterson, Teddy Bridgewater.
Julie Turner and Ralph Hammond, Bedford Common.
Okay, welcome to Bedford Common. I'm Ralph Hammond.
My co-host and citizen of the year is Julie Turner, and we have special guests. Julie, would you like to introduce our guests? Because you always do a much better job than all of us.
But of course. So we're taping the October program.
Yes.
So we want to say Happy Halloween. Oh.
I got too into watching those clips. I forgot what I was supposed to do. The winner for Best Ensemble Cast, and this shows what kind of pull you have because I was nominated and did not win, is the Bedford TV News.
Elias Orlovsky, Bedford TV Studio Promo. Hello everyone, and welcome to Bedford TV. Maria Wilson, keeping up with Bedford TV.
So, like, the other day, I was watching this Bedford TV, and I saw this promo song, and it's been stuck in my head for days.
TV, Bedford TV.
OMG, same. It's like, legit my fave.
Lauren Granada, favorite thing about Bedford TV.
Bedford TV.
It's a homey channel to watch. A lot of good segments. I like the cooking show.
Bedford TV, the wrestling guy. Yeah, he's super. And I'll watch him and a few other things, news, what's going on in Bedford.
I love Bedford TV.
I love Bedford TV.
I love Bedford TV.
My name's Peter.
My name's Rachel.
And we love Bedford TV.
Ben Oleksinski, Trailer Park Boys promo. Chris Colitti, Bedford TV News promo.
Winner for best promo is Chris Colitti, who I do not see here, so congrats, Chris. Moving along, the next category is Viewer's Choice. For Viewer's Choice, we put up a poll. We had a lot of responses. We had north of 300 total votes, and it was exceptionally close, I will say. I believe the top three were all within 7 votes. So, as of closing time, you'll find out who won after you watch the clips.
Ken Hill, Zach Martinkus, and Julian Warren. The Wrestling Connection.
Especially through social media, keep it secret that she and John have been going out for the last couple of years.
Plus, they have their other TV show, too.
Right. They have Total Divas,
Total Bellas. Yeah.
They've made no bones about that.
Right.
However, I mean, Carmella did make some valid points, okay? Where was Nikki's career going before she hooked up with John Cena?
True. I mean, from what everybody does know, I mean, she was basically like the... She was
the John Cena of the Divas division.
Yeah.
I mean, the whole...
She wasn't too shabby.
No, she was.
Jen Pula, Don Kachubis, Dan Broskell, Maria Wilson, and Jason Gould. The Bedford TV News.
Welcome, everybody, to Monday, May 16th, Bedford TV edition of the news. I'm Don Kachubis, and to my right is...
Jen Pula. Nice to see you, Don.
Oh, it's so lovely to see you. Despite the wind, your hair is looking fabulous.
You know what it was? When I got out of the car, I literally went like this to hold it down.
Oh, that was so clever.
Patty Carluccio, Pretty Simple Gardens.
And that makes your soil really nice, too. I just will sprinkle this around my garden. I will shake that off of my plants shortly. And if you do this in your garden, I promise you, your soil is going to be so much better and you're going to be able to grow things you never thought you could grow. For example, I could never get seeds to grow for years. I'd throw seeds out. It was a waste of money. Nothing ever happened. This year, because I've been putting all this stuff right back in my gardens, I have sunflowers, I have zinnias, I have morning glories, all kinds of things that I've never been able to go anywhere with for a long time.
Mike Kelly, CC Clownsby and Company.
Trick or treat. Come on, let's go, kids. Come on, we gotta go. We gotta go. Kids, we gotta go.
Mary Kay Elohian, The Legal Edition.
Studies, I started trying to publish. Mm-hmm. I did publish some scientific papers. Ultimately, Dan Olmsted and I wrote this book, The Age of Autism, which is sort of a historical view of both the environmental toxins and autism and its origins.
Right. In fact, in this book, you talk about a man-made epidemic.
That's right.
Do you want to talk a little bit about that?
Yeah.
Before I get the winner, I do want to do one thing, just because, you know, we were talking about Most Viral a little bit before, so I would really like to get a picture of all of you from the podium so we can all smile and put it on. So. One over here. Everyone look happy. I'll put those up online. Maybe it'll win next year. We'll find out. So, the winner for Viewer's Choice... Pretty Simple Garden.
Greg and Nick, and all of you, and Anne for letting me play in her garden. It's awesome. She's beautiful gardens.
But this is great, so I hope you watch it. I guess I should do a few more shows next year. This is really fun. This is great. Thanks.
We have two more awards left tonight. The first one is the Red Heat Volunteer of the Month for October, right? That's when this is. And then the last one is Red Heat Volunteer of the Year, which the nominees are formed from everyone who's won for Volunteer of the Month. So Red Heat Tavern is one of our community partners. They're nice enough to donate a $25 gift card every month to the winner of this award, and in recognition of someone who's helped out a ton over the last month. So this is a surprise for the person winning it. They don't even know they're nominated. How fun is that? But Ann Siemens is the winner of Volunteer of the Month. So I have a Red Heat gift card for you. You can come up and get Steve for all the work he does behind the scenes. Talked a lot about him tonight. The next month was Chris Kalitti, who was not here, but he did the Bedford TV News Pro we saw earlier. He helps behind the scenes on a lot of shows. He does a Mystery Science Theater style show, if anyone likes that show, where he looks at old movies and makes fun of them. It's pretty funny. Maria, who does our weather, among other things, is an intern for us. Don, who hosts Bedford Backstage, as well as the news. Mike Mahoney, the month that he won for, he helped a ton with the studio marathon. Mike was there the whole time and helped plan it out, put together our spreadsheet of when people were coming in, which we quickly, I think, tore up and just winged it, but we did a good job, I think. Pen Passering, if you have not seen his work, it's excellent. He does nature sounds where he goes out and films in nature and then plays music. I think Pen plays about 16 instruments, and he's great to have around because I get awesome music all the time. I have the best soundtrack in town. And then Wayne, as we've talked about, does Celebrate Life and many other things. So, without further ado, the Volunteer of the Year, Pat Passeri.
So first, I want to pray for all of you happy and long life, we Tibetan have one sacred mantra, Medicine Buddha's mantra. I want to recite this mantra to all of you. I hope you receive this blessing. And after that, then I will say a few words. Then I don't want to take any your sacred time. Thank you.
My
time we get to spend working together. It's excellent, so thank you, everyone.